Hi, welcome you on Jamila Devi Institute of Pharmacy YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss the structure activity relationship of beta blockers. So in the structure activity relationship of beta blocker, we have to study the various aspects which cover the core structure around which we go for the modification in the form of different substitutions. And when we go for modification in different substitutions form, how they affect the biological activity of the compound in term of their energetic beta blocker activity. It may be beta 1 blocker or it may be a beta 2 blocker. So again we look the structure of beta blocker, that is called core scaffold. Here the core scaffold of beta blocker containing two parts. One is aromatic ring and the another one is beta ethanolamine. And this core segments are interlinked by means of bridge, that is in the form of oxy bridge or in the form of methoxy bridge. We have two series of compound. The one is oxy bridge containing compound, that is called the beta ethanolamine analogs. And if you go for the methoxy bridge compound, that is come under the category of gamma propionamine derivatives. So if you look for the aromatic system, these aromatic systems may be the benzene ring, or it may the heterocyclic ring like thiadiazole, or it may be benzoheterocyclic ring like indole, or it may be the naphthalene type of ring. So we take the look on the example of these two series, that is dichloroisoprenoline, in which the system is having the beta ethanolamine type of side chain fused with the phenyl ring, while the another one in which the gamma propanolamine is fused with the naphthalene ring system. These are the two class examples. Go to the next slide, where we go for the modifications. The more common structure which is acceptable or which is more in use, that is the bridge which is having a somehow methoxy type of bridge with the beta ethanolamine fusion, because it is having a less adverse effect as compared to the system in which we have the possibility of some severe adverse effect, as well as they are also having the partial antagonist type of activity. But this type of system is having a pure antagonist type of activity. If you look for this structure, there is different type of modifications are possible. The first thing is modification take place in the aromatic ring, and generally this segment is responsible for the potency of the compound. Apart from that, they also may contribute for the selectivity, means it is having a beta 1 selectivity or beta 2 selectivity. Apart from that, they also responsible for the solubility of the compound in their biotransformation, means metabolisms or duration of action. So firstly, we take the first conditions in which the selectivity is defined, in which conditions we get the beta 1 selectivity over a non-selective, means beta 1 and beta 2 activity. So if we look for the structure, the one common feature may responsible for that is cardioselectivity or cardioselective blocker, that is the beta 1 blocker, is the presence of substitutions on the para positions. If the substitutions is present on this para positions, then the compound showing beta 1 selective blocker activity. But if the substitutions is occur on the some other place, that is on the meta place or on the ortho place, then the beta 1 selectivity is reduces, means ultimately para substituted having a maximum beta 1 selectivity over the meta or over the ortho. Apart from that, if this benzene ring is converted into a fused ring system like naphthalene one, in this case the compound is non-selective, means it having capability to block the beta 1 as well as the beta 2 receptor. Then the another conditions where the modification in aromatic ring defined the nature of the drug, that is having a partial agonist activity or competitive antagonist activity. So just take a look at the structure which is responsible for that. So here if you look, then the thing is that if the bridge is removed, as well as the para and meta substitutions is present on the aromatic ring, then the compound is dichloroisoprenoline, and this compound is having a partial agonist or antagonist activity. While if we remove this both substitution, that is chloro, dichloro one, as well as we incorporate the bridge in between the phenyl ring or benzene ring and the beta hydroxy ethanolamine, then the system is converted into somehow the gamma propionylamine derivative, and this gamma propionylamine derivative is able to show the competitive blocking activity. But in that condition, here the example is propanolol, and they are having the beta 1 and beta 2 competitive blocking activity. This is called alpha, this is called beta, and this is called the gamma. So this whole system is gamma hydroxy propylamine system, and that's why they are having the competitive inhibitor type of things, a competitive blocking activity. Then the third condition is arise when the molecule having a different pattern of their log P value. If we go for the different type of modification on this aromatic system, so just take a look of that. Here again the things is that if you have the propanolamine, means the aromatic moiety is in the form of naphthalene, their log P value is 3.10, means it is most lipophilic in nature. But if you just change the naphthalene ring with a benzene ring, and which bear the substitutions on their para position in the form of some keto system, then they have the log P value that is 0.10, that is quite polar in nature. But in place of the naphthalene ring, if we add the hexahydronaphthalene type of system, then in that conditions the log P value is lies in intermittent conditions, that is in between 3.10 and 0.10. so ultimately the substitutions which carried out on the benzene ring of beta blocker series, which defined the partition coefficient in a different pattern, and by virtue of that their bioavailability has changed, their onset of action is altered, or their metabolic phenomena is changed. In the another conditions, the biotransformation pathways, how this compound or these derivatives is undergo for the metabolisms. So ultimately the things is only that how we can change the substitutions on the benzene ring, or this benzene ring is converted into fusing systems, as well as the substitution in the form of some group or moiety on the para positions or on meta positions or on ortho positions, or it may be on the both ortho position, or it may be on both meta positions, then how the bio transformation is changed. So generally the more lipophilic drugs are cleared by the liver, but the patient who suffered from the liver disease, in that case the clearance is somehow affected. And similarly, the less lipophilic compound in which the para substitution is some having a polar group type of things, or this meta substitution having polar group of type of things, then their clearance major take place through the kidney. And in that conditions, there is need to adjust the dose of the beta blocker if there is impaired renal functions. So ultimately the polar group is responsible for the major segment clear through the kidney, while the non-polar substitutions is responsible for major clearance occur through the liver. Then again, this whole things affect the half-life of the compound also. If you look here, the one compound that is bitaxolol, which having the ether bridge, and definitely the non-polar moiety, in that conditions their half-life is somehow increases. It may vary from 14 to 22 hours, but if you go for propranolol, in which there is the substitutions are absence on the aromatic ring, they have the fused ring system, their half-life is from 4 to 6 hours. But if some esters are there, like ismolol, then their half-life is very short, that is 9 minutes. This esters is undergo for hydrolysis by means of esterase enzymes and give the corresponding acid, which can be easily undergo for the metabolism, and due to that the half-life is very less. And the rest of the portion, if you look, that is remain intake in all the molecules, that is remain same. So these things indicate that the half-life is depend on the aromatic portion or aromatic area of the molecules. The next, how bridge affect the activity of beta blockers. So this oxybris can be replaced by bioisosteer. The O can be replaced by the NCS3. Are there another bioisosteer that is sulfur or that is methylene or methylene type of things? In that condition, the activity of the compound is decreases. In all the condition when we replace the oxygen by the nitrogen, in which the actually the bioisosteer of oxygen is NH, but here we replace it with the NCS3. In this conditions, the activity is decreased, and another bioisosteer for oxygen is sulfur. Again, activity is decreased. Oxygen is changed with CH2 group. Again, activity is decreases, and when change methylene, then there is little or no activity. So this whole data support that the oxygen is crucial for the optimum activity. Then the things how hydroxy group is responsible for the activity. So here on the beta carbon there is the hydroxy group, and this hydroxy group is present in the form of some enantiomeric form. It may be the R enantiomer or it may be S enantiomer. At this beta carbon, the S configurations so better activity, means this hydroxy group is below the plane is favor for the activity, that is the condition is this one, that is below the plane is favor for the activity. And at the same time, if this hydroxy group is having, or this chiral center having a R configurations, then it is less active, means this hydroxy group is above the plane, then so the less activity. This is actually happened if you look for the interaction with the beta receptor, then this hydroxy group is participated in the hydrogen bond with the amino acid present on the receptor surface. So definitely the three dimension orientation of this hydroxy group is crucial, and that's why if this is the chiral center, so there is the two enantiomer is possible. One is favor for the activity, while another is not support the activity up to the same extent as the previous form. As well as this hydroxy is also essential for the activity, because it undergo for the hydrogen bond formation. So take example of this two enantiomeric form. The example is propanolol, where in the S configurations the hydroxy group lie below the plane, and this S configurations having a approximate more than 100-fold activity as compared to the R configuration, where this hydroxy group is lie above the plane. So definitely the S form on beta carbon is favor for the activity over a R configuration. Then the next structure modifications which may be take place on the terminal nitrogen, which is present in the form of propanolamine, that is this one, this terminal having in the form of NH2. So generally if it is NH2, then it is in the form of primary amine. But for the beta blocker activity, this nitrogen must be in the secondary amines, means it is must be in the form of NHR group, as well as it might occur in the form of the tertiary, that is NR2, then it so somehow less activity because there may be a strict hindrance. Only the amines and physiological pH is converted into quaternary salt, and this quaternary salt is undergo for hydrogen bond formation with the counterpart which present on the enzymes. So definitely for optimum activity, this must be in the form of secondary amine, no tertiary or no quaternary. Then if it is in the secondary amine, then what is the nature of R group? So look for that. This R group must be having carbon equivalent to 3 or more than 3, as well as it is favor of branch substitutions on this position in the form of isopropyl or tertiary butyl type of things. So the group can only be a secondary substitutions, and branch is the optimal choice for the activity. And generally tertiary butyl or isopropyl, so the optimum activity, and that carbon chain length is equivalent to 3 carbon or more than 3 carbon, then it's so the beta blocking activity. The example of beta blocker, if that carbon chain length is increases like the labetalol, this is branching is there, but this is more than the 4 come in the terminal segment having a phenyl ring also. So in this case they have the beta blocker activity, but with beta blocker they also having a alpha 1 blocking action. Similarly, if you look for carbidolol, where again the carbon chain is increases, then they also show the alpha 1 blocking activity. Then another possibilities, there is the alpha carbon is there, beta carbon is there, and the gamma carbon is there. So generally it is in the form of methylene and methylene type of system. Then they have the two hydrogen, and this two hydrogens can be go for change by means of alkyl group, or any one of them can be changed by alkyl group. If we go for substitutions by means of small alkyl group like methyl on this alpha, beta, this alpha carbon, this beta carbon, or this gamma carbon, then in each conditions they lower the beta blockage or beta blocker activity, especially for the alpha carbon, where the activity is dramatically decreased. So these are the SARs. We just try to summarize the overall SAR of beta blocker, take a look of different possibilities around the structures. We already discussed this phenyl ring is crucial for the potency, the biotransformation, the absorption, as well as the selectivity of the analogs. If you look for bridge, this bridge is somehow responsible for the selective competitive inhibitions as compared to partial agonist or antagonist. Apart from that, again this bridge must be bearing oxygen. Then another thing, the chirality which present on the beta carbon, so S configurations is favor for the activity over R configuration at this chiral center, as well as this hydroxy group is crucial for the activity. So beta receptor blocking is highly stereoselective, and this hydroxy group is crucial for it play a key role in the hydrogen bond formation with the receptor. Similarly, the terminal amine portion is must be in the form of secondary amines, as well as the substitutions of secondary amine, that is R, is having a carbon chain length 3 or more than that, and it should be in the branch form, which favor for the activity. And if we look for the hydrogen which present here at a biological pH, it is converted into quaternary ammonium derivative, then this quaternary ammonium hydrogen is undergo for participations in the hydrogen bond with the counterpart which present on the receptor surface. So this is the overall summary of the beta blocker, and thanks to all of you for patiently listening the SAR. If you have any query regarding the SAR, then feel free and ask in the form of comments, so we can able to answer you. Thanks once again.